Arctotherium versus Daeodon. Who would win a legendary battle? Arctotherium was the largest bear to ever exist. It inhabited South America and chased off even jaguars. What if they went head to head against the largest Entelodont ever existed, the Dinohyus? Let us find out here on Animal Green Corner. Size. Male Arctotheriums were 1.8 meters tall at the shoulders, while being 3 to 4.3 meters tall when stood on their hinds. It was 900 to 1,750 kilograms and was 3.7 to 4.3 meters long. The Dinohyus was 1.77 meters tall at the shoulders, while being 3.6 to 3.8 meters long. Having the closest relation to pigs, Dinohyus at its prime was 650 to 1,400 kilograms in mass. Diet of these animals are little known. Though the Arctotherium's modern relative, the spectacled bear was a strong herbivore. The teeth and body structure suggests that it was either an omnivore or a scavenger. Its opponent had eaten nuts, roots, vines, bushes, meat and bones and possibly, carrion. These are theories. Habitat. The bear inhabited South America about 2 million to 50,000 years ago. It is better to say, restricted to South America, the Entelodont was inhabiting the dense forests, expansive prairies and bushy landscapes, about 23 to 20 million years ago. It was dominating on its times. Now to the fight analysis. The intelligence between the fighters is not measured. But, using our analysis, we could say that bear was very aware of its surroundings. It was like other bears, aggressive if threatened and in short words, more decent. The Entelodonts were very savage and careless, who relied purely in strength. So, the bear is smarter. But, the Dinohyus was fiercer. This could also turn out as a weakness of underestimating others. The reason why Daeodon is extinct due to the arrival of Amphicyon. He relied on strength only and were literally starved to extinction by a much evolved, smarter, social predator, the Amphicyon. The bear was much experienced in combat. About 23 million years ago, the dominant predator was the Hyaenodon and a few smaller predators. But when Entelodonts arrived, they were 270 kilograms, as heavy as a coastal Barbary lion. But once the climate got harsher, the response was to get bigger into Daeodon Shoshonensis. The reign ended with the arrival of Amphicyon, about 20 million years ago. The short-faced bears were Arctotus and Arctotherium. The former inhabited North America, while the latter lived on South America. The Arctotherium had much experience than its foe and was much evolved. It faced tough competition with dire wolves, Smilodon populator and early humans. The bear had more balance while the Daeodon had more agility. Apart from your thoughts, these heavyweights were fast runners. The Arctotherium's top speed was about 72 kilometers per hour. The Daeodon outran the camelids at a whopping 60 to 75 kilometers per hour. But when talking about bite effectiveness, which I researched a lot, it was between 1,800 to 4,045 psi for the Daeodon and 1,000 to 1,400 psi for Arctotherium. Onto their strengths. The main power of the bear came from here, its jaws and forepaws. The bear was built robustly and were in clear, more muscular than any Daeodons. The fur would be useless against the Daeodon's jaws. The Daeodon relied on the jaws and strong tusks and powerful, hoofed legs. The jaws can also toss the enemy. Now, it is time for the battle. Who would win a ferocious fight? On the first corner, there is Arctotherium ungustidens, holding the edge in size, build, endurance, intelligence, balance, paw strength and muscle mass. On the second corner, we have Daeodon shoshonensis holding the edge in bite strength, agility, speed, aggression and biting reach. The bear is the hot favorite to win the majority due to its advantages, but it should detect the weaknesses of the Entelodont. The Dinohyus isn't an easy pushover. One bite to the bear's neck would end the game. And if the bear is stupid enough to bite the Daeodon, it would cause its life. The skull, as you see, is small for the bear. The bear would use its swipe property, as trying to bite would put it in a very close range and the agile Daeodon would kill it with a bite. It should use the Daeodon's advantage as its weakness. It shouldn't stay in the close range and should swipe its foe repeatedly in the underbelly, chest or neck, giving the bear 60% chances. It is a very close fight. This is the most usual scenario. It may change sometimes, if the Dinohyus's striking momentum would simply snap the bear in two. It should avoid the massive paws and attack as quickly as possible. The jaws will do the dirty work. The Daeodon may win, but on the majority, tables could turn. If the bear uses all his advantages, then, he is the big winner.